This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Spring Street Financial District, referred to as the Wall Street of the West, is a historic district in downtown Los Angeles. The historic district includes 23 financial structures, including the city's first skyscraper, and 3 hotels, all located along a stretch of South Spring Street from just north of 4th Street to just south of 7th Streets in the first half of the 20th century. This stretch of Spring Street was the financial center of Los Angeles, with the important banks and financial institutions being concentrated there. At least 10 of the buildings in the district were designed in whole or in part by John Parkinson, who designed many of the city's landmark buildings in the early 20th century, including the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, Los Angeles City Hall, Bullocks Wilshire, and Union Station. 10 of the buildings in the district have been designated as historic cultural monuments by the Los Angeles Cultural Heritage Commission. Contents: 1. History: 11. Early days: 12. Wall Street of the West: 13. Decline of the district in the 1970s and 1980s: 14. Redevelopment projects and regentrification: 15. Beaux-Arts architecture as the district's enduring strength: 2 buildings in the district, 3 historic designation and walking tours, 4 image gallery, 5 see also, 6 references, 7 external links. History: Continental Building, LA's first skyscraper. Early days in the 1890s, the city's business center was further north near South Spring and Temple Streets. The street can claim credit as the birthplace of the motion picture business in Los Angeles. In 1898, Thomas Edison filmed a 60-second film titled South Spring Street, Los Angeles, California, mounting a giant camera on a wagon to film the bustling action along South Spring Street. Wall Street of the West: in the early 1900s, the city center began spreading south, and the city's banks and financial institutions began concentrating along South Spring Street. The first two important buildings to make the move south were the Hellman and Continental Buildings, with the Continental Building being considered the city's first skyscraper in 1911. The Los Angeles Times boasted about the building boom on Spring Street. The visitor to this city can at this moment observe skyscrapers in all stages of construction. It is a study which will provide the most comprehensible kind of answer to the query as to why Los Angeles is leading San Francisco, Portland, Seattle, St. Louis, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Cincinnati, Baltimore, Detroit, Minneapolis, New Orleans, Boston, Buffalo, and all other cities of anything near her in building activity as revealed by the monthly expenditures for construction work. The building boom along South Spring Street continued into the 1920s as the population and economy of Los Angeles boomed. South Spring Street remained the city's financial center even after World War II. Decline of the district in the 1970s and 1980s. Decorations above entrance to E.F. Hutton Building in the 1960s. Many of the banks and financial institutions began moving to the western part of the downtown area, along Figueroa Street and Wilshire Boulevard by the early 1980s. South Spring Street had become known for transients who sleep in doorways and urinate on sidewalks. In 1982, the Los Angeles Times commented on the district's decline from Wall Street of the West to a blighted area with empty office buildings lining both sides of the street. When the banks and law firms moved to the Gold Coast, typified by Arco Towers, 6 blocks to the west, Spring Street plummeted to become a neighborhood of hoodlums, derelicts, and winos, a neighborhood of echoing buildings full of absolutely nothing above the ground floor. Redevelopment projects and regentrification: since the early 1980s, South Spring Street has been the subject of numerous redevelopment projects in recent years. Numerous art galleries have moved into the old financial district, which is now known as Gallery Row. Many of the old bank buildings have also been converted into upscale lofts as wealthier residents have moved into the district's lofts. Older residents and artists have complained about the increased rents. One artist who had lived in the district for years said, "The real problem with downtown lately," Gronk and his friends half-jokingly agreed, "is those people, Westsiders trust fund babies, new tenants who demand their bohemian pleasures be liberally sweetened with suburban amenities, landlords who previously recruited artists to help make downtown safe for gentrification, then jacked up their rents so only lawyers and screenwriters could afford it." Beaux-Arts architecture is the district's enduring strength. Moderna exterior of the Title Insurance Building: the strength of the district remains its period architecture. Many of the Beaux-Arts facades along Spring Street remain virtually intact, making the district a popular shooting location for motion picture and television productions seeking authentic period cityscapes. In 1985, noted Los Angeles Times columnist Jack Smith pointed to the Spring Street Financial District as proof that Los Angeles was never the cultural wasteland it was alleged to be. He hailed the district's
financial palaces
as
a solid architectural achievement which give the street
beauty, strength, unity and dignity.
Buildings in the district. Notable buildings in the district from north to south include
the Hellman Building, nay corner of 4th and Spring, built in 1902.
The Hellman and Continental buildings were the first major structures to anchor the Spring Street financial district.
The Hellman Building, now known as Banco Popular, is an 8-story brick and concrete structure designed by Alfred Rosenheim in 1998. Gilmore Associates announced plans to convert the Hellman Building, the Continental Building, and the San Fernando Building into 230 lofts. The converted buildings consisted of large, open lofts with high ceilings and no interior walls. Except for the bathrooms, the conversion was designed by architect Wade Killifer, who noted, "What lends these buildings to residential use is lots of windows and high ceilings, offering wonderful light." The combined project became known as the Old Bank District Lofts. The Continental Building, 408 South Spring Street, built in 1902. The Continental Building was originally known as the Brawley Building. The 12-story building was designed by John Parkinson and is considered the first skyscraper in Los Angeles. It was the tallest building in Los Angeles until 1907. It is known for its highly ornamental cornice and bands. The Continental Building was converted into lofts as part of Tom Gilmore's Old Bank District Lofts project. It was designated a historic cultural landmark HCM number 730 in 2002. El Dorado Hotel, 416 South Spring Street, originally known as the Hotel Stowell. The 12-story hotel was built in 1913 and designed by Frederick Noonan with a highly stylized and brightly colored facade. Enameled brick and terracotta bachelder tiles are used extensively in the hotel and lobby. Shortly after the hotel opened, Charlie Chaplin lived at the Stowell, which he described as a middle-rate place but new and comfortable. Chaplin later told a story about receiving a telephone call while there concerning an appearance for which he was to be paid $25,000. Chaplin recalled, "My bedroom window opened out on the well of the hotel, so that the voice of anyone talking resounded through the rooms. The telephone connection was bad. I don't intend to pass up $25,000 for 2 weeks' work. I had to shout several times. A window opened above and a voice shouted back, 'Cut out that bull and go to sleep, you big dope.'" In 2008, the building was converted into lofts under the name El Dorado Lofts. Title Insurance Building, 433 South Spring Street, built in 1928. The Title Insurance Building is a 10-story building designed by John and Donald Parkinson in the zigzag Moderna style. The marble lobby includes a mural by Hugo Ballin. The Title Insurance Building was the subject of the district's first major redevelopment project. Architect developer Ragnar C. Cavalli acquired the building in 1979. He took the impressive Art Deco shell and converted the building into the design center of Los Angeles, which he leased to wholesale household furniture showrooms. Early 2011, the ground floor of the building became an art gallery and coffee shop, and took the logical name of Ground Floor Gallery. Financial District into the city's Gallery Row. The building's interior features original Art Deco designs, Art Nouveau details, sculptured brass, Italian marble, bachelder tile, California alder and tiger oak. The building's tenants include artists, designers, architects, film production companies, and law firms. A nightclub called the Crocker Club is scheduled to open on the vault floor in 2008. Rowan Building, 131 West 5th Street, built in 1910. The 11-story Rowan Building was originally known as the Chester Building, designed by Parkinson. Features including Carrara marble corridor walls and floors, mahogany windows, and detailed Art Deco elevator doors have been preserved. Alexandria Hotel, 210 West 5th Street, built in 1906. The 8-story Alexandria Hotel is another building designed by John Parkinson with 500 rooms, an elaborate wood lobby, and the glamorous palm court with its stained glass dome. The Alexandria was the most luxurious hotel in Los Angeles from the time it opened until the Biltmore opened in the mid-1920s. Movie stars and other celebrities, including Mae West, Humphrey Bogart, Rudolph Valentino, Clark Gable, Greta Garbo, Sarah Bernhardt, Enrico Caruso and Jack Dempsey were guests. Charlie Chaplin kept a suite at the Alexandria and did improvisations in the lobby, where Tom Mix reportedly rode his horse. The carpet in the lobby was called the $1 million carpet, because there was purportedly a $1 million worth of business done there every day. It was there that D.W. Griffith, Mary Pickford and Douglas Fairbanks met in 1919 to form United Artists U.S. Presidents Theodore Roosevelt, William Howard Taft and Woodrow Wilson, and many foreign dignitaries, including King Edward VIII, also stayed at the hotel while visiting Los Angeles. The hotel declined after the Biltmore opened and closed in 1934, with its chandelier and gold leaf covering of the mezzanine lobby being stripped and sold. It reopened in 1937 but declined again in the 1950s, become a transient hotel with the Grand Ballroom being used as a training ring for boxers today. The Alexandria has been converted to apartments. The Palm Court in the Alexandria was designated a historic cultural landmark HCM No. 80 in 1971. Security Building 510 South Spring Street, built in 1906. The 11-story steel frame security building was designed in an Italianate style by Parkinson and Bergstrom when it was built. It was the tallest building in Los Angeles, surpassing the Continental Building. It remained the city's tallest building until 1911. The Security Building has been converted to lofts operated under the name The Lofts at the Security Building. The Security Building was designated a historic cultural landmark HCM No. 741 in 2003. Los Angeles Theater Center 514 South Spring Street, built in 1916. The one-story building was designed by John Parkinson in a Greek Revival style with Ionic columns in addition to the columns. The building is known for its lobby with a large 50 by 100 foot 30. Trouble and was forced to close. However, it was later reopened by the City Spring Arcade Building 541 South Spring Street, built in 1924. The 12-story, double-wing arcade building, designed by architects Kenneth MacDonald and Maurice Couchot, includes a cavernous mid-block arcade connecting Spring Street with Broadway. Originally known as the Mercantile Arcade Building, it was modeled on the Burlington Arcade in London, England. Is three-level, skylighted arcade has been called a space as regal as almost any other interior space in the city. The tower on top of the building once supported the antenna of the radio station KRKD, RKD equals arcade, from which Amy Semple McPherson preached her message. The ups and downs of the district were reflected in the sales of the arcade building as the area fell into decline. It sold in 1977 for $300,000 5 years later, as redevelopment projects fueled speculation in Spring Street properties. It sold for $45 million, 15 times its 1977 sale price. Lloyd's Bank 548 South Spring Street, built in 1913. The 12-story Lloyd's Bank was designed in the commercial style by William Curlett. NW corner of 6th and Spring, built in 1910. The 11-story Pacific Southwest Bank was designed by Parkinson. Samuel London in the Moderna style ground was broken in October 1929, just as the Great Depression hit, and when the Los Angeles Stock Exchange opened its doors there in 1931. The country was deep into the Depression. There are three bas-relief panels carved by Salvatore Carteno Scarpitta into the granite above the building's entrance. The panels portray the elements of a capitalist economy. The large central panel, finance, displays capitalists. The production panel shows an aircraft engine, a steel worker pouring molten metal, and a worker stirring it. The research and discovery panel shows oil derricks, factories, a chemist conducting an experiment, and a man kneeling in a library reading a book. The interior is wonderfully preserved, and has ancient Near East and native Indian influences by the designer Julian Ellsworth Garnsey. On the entrance lobby's ceiling, the Wilson Studio created four sculpted figures representing speed Mercury, accuracy the Archer, permanence a figure contemplating the universe, and equality the figure bearing scales. The highlight of the interior was its massive 90 feet by 74 feet balconied trading floor with a 40-foot ceiling and 64 booths. On fifth floor was a clearing house with a statistics department, an auditorium, and a lecture room. Offices occupied floors 6 through 9, and the top two floors included a club with a library, a card room, a billiard room, and reading rooms. The basement held a 2,660 square ft printing room and a vault. In 1986, the exchange, by then part of the Pacific Stock Exchange, moved out of the building in the late 1980s. The Community Redevelopment Agency helped fund a nightclub that opened in the Exchange Building, called the Stock Exchange, but the club did not survive the 1980s. In late 2008, the building underwent extensive renovations and reopened in 2010 as Exchange LA Nightclub. The visually dynamic building and interiors are frequently used for location filming, and has been featured in The Big Lebowski, The Social Network, and numerous television shows and commercials. Special events include corporate parties, product debuts, and fashion shows. The Stock Exchange building was
designated a historic cultural landmark HCM No. 205 in 1979. E.F. Hutton Building, 623 South Spring Street, built in 1931. The 12-story zig-zag Moderna E.F. Hutton Building once housed E.F. Hutton's Big Board. The Hutton and California Canadian Bank were the first office buildings to be converted into residences in 1984. The Community Redevelopment Agency converted the adjacent towers into 121 condominiums in a project called Premier Towers. However, when most of the units failed to sell, the agency sold the project to a developer who offered the units for rental, in the process destroying property values for those who had purchased units. California Canadian Bank, 625 South Spring Street, built in 1923. The 12-story neoclassical building includes terracotta ornamentation on the top two levels. The building is now part of the Premier Towers project. With the E.F. Hutton Building Mortgage Guarantee Building, 626 South Spring Street, built in 1913, the six-story Mortgage Guarantee Building, also known as the Sassoni Building, has a decorative cornice and fluted columns. In 2004, the structure was converted into 36 apartments called City Lofts by developer Isaac Shomoff Banks. Oil Building and served as the headquarters of Union Oil Company until 1923. The building was designed by Parkinson. Historic Cultural Landmark HCM No. 898 in 2007. Historic designation and walking tours. Due to the large percentage of historic bank and financial buildings that remain intact in the district, the area was listed on the National Register of Historic Places in 1979. The Los Angeles Conservancy offers walking tours of the Spring Street Financial District on the fourth Saturday of each month at 10 a.m. The tour lasts approximately 2 to 1/2 hour and costs $10 for the general public. Reduced rate for Conservancy members. Image Gallery. Hellman Building. Title Insurance Building. Crocker Bank. Los Angeles Theater Center. Rowan Building. Alexandria Hotel. Security Building. Arcade Building. Pacific Southwest Bank. Hotel Hayward Banks. Huntley Building. Mortgage Guarantee Building. Los Angeles Stock Exchange. California Canadian Bank. Lloyds Bank. Bartlett Building. Barclays Bank. Bank of America Financial Center Building. Van Nuys Building. See also Wikimedia Commons has media related to Spring Street. Los Angeles. Los Angeles Portal. List of registered historic places in Los Angeles. International Savings Carrot. National Park Service. The 15th of April 2008. National Register Information System. National Register of Historic Places. National Park Service. Skyscrapers. Staggering sum going into metropolitan blocks. Downtown skyline daily grows more imposing. Los Angeles Times. The 15th of April 1911. Carrot. Robert A. Jones. The 6th of December 1998. The Distant Sound of a Miracle. Los Angeles Times. Times. Street. Los Angeles Times. E. U.S. National Register of Historic Places. Topics. Architectural style categories. Contributing property. Historic district. History of the National Register of Historic Places. Keeper of the Register. National Park Service. Property types. Lists by states. Alabama. Alaska. Arizona. Arkansas. California. Colorado. Connecticut. Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming. Lists by insular areas. American Samoa, Guam. Minor outlying islands. Northern Mariana Islands. Puerto Rico. Virgin Islands. Lists by associated states. Federated States of Micronesia. Marshall Islands. Palau. Other areas. District of Columbia. Morocco. Portal. Wiki Project VE. Historic districts in Los Angeles County. 20th Street. 27th Street. 52nd Place. Alvarado Terrace. Arroyo Seco Parkway. Broadway. Bungalow Heaven. Pasadena Civic Center. Pasadena Edison. Pomona. Ford Place. Pasadena Hollywood Boulevard. Lincoln Park. Pomona. Little Tokyo. Pueblo de Los Angeles Plaza. Lower Arroyo Seco. Pasadena Menlo Avenue West. 29th Street North. Harper Avenue West. Hollywood North. University Park. Old Pasadena Park Place. Arroyo Terrace. Pasadena Pegfair Estates. Pasadena Pisgah Home. Poppy Peak. Pasadena Prospect. Pasadena Redondo Beach. Original Townsite. Russian Village. Claremont South. Marengo. Pasadena S. Bonnie Bray. South Pasadena. South Serrano Avenue. Spring Street. St. James Park. Van Buren Place. Venice Canal. Washington Court. Pasadena. Whitley Heights. Wilton VE. Downtown area. Los Angeles districts and neighborhoods. Arts District. Bunker Hill. Chinatown Civic Center Fashion District Financial District Gallery Row Historic Core Jewelry District Little Tokyo No Junction Old Bank District Skid Row South Park Spring Street Financial District Toy District Wholesale District Points of Interest Angels Flight The Broad Broadway Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels City Hall Convention Center Grand Park LA Live Mocha Music Center Olvera Street Pershing Square Staples Center Union Station LA Regions Crescenta Valley Downtown Eastside Harbor Area Greater Northeast LA Northwest LA San Fernando Valley South LA Westside Wilshire Mid City West Mid Wilshire